Arrow Season 6, Episode 7, Thanksgiving. This is a very special episode because, of course, this episode actually premiered on the holiday, which, you know, I mentioned during my Supernatural review. I think these two episodes actually showing up on Thanksgiving was a mistake. They just were like, you know, boom, start this week, and then they just forgot to, you know, not do it. I don't know. But either way, got a pretty decent episode this week. We get to see Laurel and Kate and James come back into the fold and kind of move forward in the, like, the next step of their plan. This just being one of the sort of in-between moments where it's like, yeah, you know, not really a bomb, but we do have the ingredients to make a very serious bomb in the future. But for now, that was kind of just a ploy to make a fake bomb to get you guys here to beat up on a bunch of fake cops and put that video out, which of course allowed for, you know, the possibility to sway the vote, which it certainly did, and now people don't want vigilantes. So, you know, things have definitely gotten a little bit tougher. Of course, we have our FBI agent doing her thing, just coming in the beginning of the episode, actually arresting Oliver. Now he has to go through his trial. I don't know how Curtis is going to react, but man, I cannot believe Felicity spent all, you know, their money, their investment money to get him out of jail. It was super funny. That was like the big thing, like, oh man, Oliver's arrested again. That was like hardly an issue in the episode. Like, he got arrested and then he was out most of the episode because they paid the bail super fast. So most of the episode he was just up, you know, walking around doing his thing, and I was like, oh, you know, him being arrested was, it's a big deal because, you know, the trial's coming along. I think it was the DA, the city DA, is actually the prosecution because the FBI has so much evidence and it's, you know, something within the city. So, excuse me, that was a big deal as well. Naturally, there's a ton of evidence that we have yet to see. So looking forward to how in the world that's going to play out, because they're like, you know, we have a ton of evidence that is going to help prove that Oliver Queen is the Green Arrow. We'll see how serious this evidence really is, but there's evidence out there for sure. So I can't wait to see how all this ultimately ends up playing out, this whole big crazy court case, but I'm looking forward to that. Another big story this episode was definitely Diggle, him going through the process of the tremors and the degenerative cell issues, which unfortunately are, like, worsened in this episode. We find out that him utilizing Curtis's experimental serum, pretty much, it was an issue because it was that plus the fact that he was having withdrawals, and him using the initial experimental drug that he was using to stop the tremors, that led to issues, you know, the issues going to his spine, and that could lead to paralysis if he stays in the field. And they talk about how it's permanent, but at the end of the episode, Oliver's like, you know, once you're healed up and everything's all said and done, I want you back out there as the Green Arrow. And it was like, okay, well, he mentioned how permanent this stuff was. I don't know what they're going to do, but Felicity was also permanently paralyzed, so maybe they can actually figure it out. It was a different, you know, that was kind of the point, was that they technically use something for the spine on his arm. And, you know, that led to some issues, plus obviously the withdrawals and everything he did using this experimental drug in the first place, and then the withdrawal of that said experimental drug, and then the application of yet another experimental drug. So Diggle's all sorts of messed up right now, but they, you know, they make it seem hopeful at the end, even though he said stuff was permanent. It's like, you know, once you're healed, you'll be back out there as Green Arrow, which leads to an interesting moment where Diggle cannot be out in the field. He gets beat up early on in this episode, and he's down for the count, and Oliver does have to take over as Green Arrow in this episode. And I thought, that's interesting, and with the way things are kind of going, Diggle can't possibly take over, and people will notice that the Green Arrow's not there. So I think Oliver, even though this isn't what he wants to do, and of course this was like that first moment at the end of the episode where he has to lie to his son, it's like, oh, well, you know, Mr. Diggle, if you weren't there, then, you know, who's the Green Arrow? And Oliver has to lie and say, like, oh, the Green Arrow wasn't there, it was just his team. It's like, oh, okay. So, you know, I'm assuming that has to just be the start, because they aren't going to go out with no leader. They aren't going to go out without the Green Arrow, even if they can manage it. You know, the concept is still there. It's like, oh, no Green Arrow, that's funny, it's just the team. What's he up to, and, you know, what's going on there? So, I don't know how they're going to work around it. I'm sure at this point, Oliver will just be taking over the mantle. Probably will take a minute, maybe we won't get that until, like, next year's set of episodes, but Thea does come back at the end of this episode, which is awesome, so we might get to see Speedy come back, which is pretty cool, because I was waiting, I was like, man, when is she gonna, you know, wake up and they kind of bring her back into the fold? So I was really happy at the end of this episode when she wakes up, and it's like, alright, now she can get back to training and kind of building herself back up and get out in the field again as well. Who knows how that'll play out as far as, you know, the whole crazy FBI investigation. It's like, oh, suddenly your sister wakes up, and then poof, here comes Speedy all over again. So, little stuff like that they might touch on, they might not. certain elements, they really got to be careful. You know, all eyes are on the entire team, especially Oliver, but the whole team is being checked on right now, so they really got to be careful with that. But I'm looking forward in general to seeing how things start to evolve, you know, with this season going forward, because it does seem like Diggle's going to be out of it for a minute. So Oliver will be taking over again, lying to his son about being Green Arrow. Thea will come in. I assume that she'll come back in as Speedy. We'll see how that plays out. If they do decide to touch on it, you know, them being smart enough to be like, okay, Thea's back, so is Speedy. Super duper suspicious. So maybe they'll hold off on that and, you know, kind of work around things. Plus they have the actual case coming up. Who knows what evidence we haven't seen actually get built upon, but for now it's just all speculation that we've seen. But who knows what actual evidence there is, because she's making everything seem super confident and like, hey, you know, being honest is just going to make it easier. But also that's what everyone does. Like, every cop ever will be like, hey, already got this evidence, you know, like your buddy said this, so I don't know if you want to say this or that, you know, that sort of thing. So you see that all the time in TV, and that's pretty much where it happens. It's TV all the time where they say they have so much and they try to get you to admit it, but they don't really have it. So we'll see what ends up happening. I wouldn't be surprised if there was like another villain. I don't know why Malcolm Merlyn would do it, but I don't know. Malcolm Merlyn comes in, is like, yeah, he's totally Green Arrow. Somebody comes in, I don't know, but we'll see how it plays out, but I'm definitely looking forward to where things are headed this season. This episode, I think, was definitely a nice little bit of change where it's like, oh, we had Diggle going through his process, and I thought he was going to get better, but it actually ended up being worse, which leads to, you know, that extra sense of tension where now Oliver does have to take over as being Green Arrow again because he knows what's actually going on with Diggle. And I'm just looking forward to how this is going to play out. I'm sure at some point it will blow up in his face. It's like, oh, he lied to his son. I don't know how they're going to handle this whole FBI case deal. I don't think they'll get busted ultimately, but I am excited to see how they find their ways, you know, how they find themselves getting out of it on the, you know, the right side of things when it's all said and done. So looking forward to where we're headed, but this is definitely a cool episode. Naturally, next week is the 2-week crossover. I don't know how much of an impact that's really going to have on Arrow, because that's basically a 2-night event. So it's, you know, Monday, Tuesday. So we'll see how that, you know, really impacts the show and, you know, those characters going over. I would assume it's just going to be, I think, Oliver. I want to say Thea is in the crossover. I didn't want to look at the pictures because I know there are, like, a ton of people that show up. Some people from, like, alternate worlds and stuff. And I was like, I've seen too many glimpses. I don't want to know exactly who's going to show up because there are a couple of cool surprises in there. So I was like, I'm just going to stay away and just, I'll see what happens when it happens. Because they always do that where it's, like, some random person will show up and it's like, oh, I didn't see that coming. They already have it in the promo where there's going to be another Reverse Flash. So that's already a huge deal, which I'm assuming that's a Reverse Flash from another Earth. But still, Reverse Flash is coming back. So I really don't want to know all the characters that are going to show up. So I've been kind of avoiding that. So I don't know if Thea is going to be in there. But obviously, Oliver's going to be there. I'm pretty sure Renee was in one of the pictures. And I don't know if Dinah was. Although it wouldn't make sense that she wouldn't be. So they're probably going to have everybody except for Diggle. And probably not Thea, just because, you know, I would assume she has to take a bit more time to recuperate, but they might show up at some point, because, I mean, it is Barry and Iris's wedding. I'm sure those characters will be in there in some, you know, some aspect. That's actually, now I think about it, that's probably why Thea woke up this episode, is because it's like, everyone has to be at the wedding, so that's probably why that happened. So, I was like, oh yeah, like, you know, Barry, for people who don't watch The Flash, or not Barry, but Wally, he left for a minute, and then he came back, and I was like, he was only gone for, like, 2 episodes, and I was like, oh, yeah, the wedding episode is, like, next week. Everyone has to be in the same place, so it just made sense when I thought about it, like, oh, that's why he came back, because the wedding episode, everybody has to be at the wedding. So they have to, like, reintroduce all the characters in the regular episodes, and then everyone's already been there during the crossover, although they could have just done some of the surprises, but it's a crossover. It's like, let's get all the surprises out of the way. This person's back, that person's back. So we'll see how relevant Thea and Diggle are to the crossover, but definitely looking forward to that. And, you know, whatever the next episode is going to be, because everything has been promoing just the crossover, so, like, all of next week, I don't know what any of the actual episodes are going to be. I don't look anything up, so I don't know outside of the crossover. But looking forward to that. Of course, would love to know what you guys thought about this episode. So please comment below. Let me know your favorite parts about it, least favorite parts about it. And with where we are right now, Diggle being out of commission, Thea waking up, Oliver possibly going back out as, you know, the Green Arrow until Diggle is healed, which I'm sure won't be anytime soon. I would love to know how you guys think this is actually going to fall apart. It has to. It's television. It will not work perfectly. Something will go wrong. I think it'll be a bit beyond just William finds out that, you know, Oliver has actually been going around as Green Arrow again. So I think it'll go a bit worse than just that. So I would love to know your theories on how bad things are going to get and how they're ultimately going to fall apart. And of course, I just want to know what you guys thought about this episode in general. So please comment below, let me know, and thanks for watching.